All the world's a stage, and all the men and women merely players. They have their exits and their entrances, and one man in his time plays many parts.
Yet for God's sake, come on to these wars. The time was, Father, that you broke your word when you were more endeared to it than now. When your own Percy, when my heart's dear Harry, through many a northward look to see his father bring up his powers, but he did long in vain. Who then persuaded you to stay at home? There were two honors lost, yours and your son's. For yours, may the God in heaven brighten. For his, it stuck upon him as the sun in the gray vaults of heaven, and by his light did all the chivalry of England move to do brave acts. He was indeed the glass wherein the noble youths address themselves. Yet no legs that practice not in his gait. And speaking thick, which nature made his blemish, became the accents of the valiant. For those that could speak low and tardily would turn their own perfection to abuse to seem like him. So that in speech, in gait, in diet, affections of delight, military rules, humors of blood, he was the mock and glass, copy and book that fashioned others. Oh, wondrous him. Miracle of men, him did you leave, second to none, unseconded by you, to look upon the hideous god of war in disadvantage. To bide a field wherein nothing but the sound of Hotspur's name did seem defensible. So you left him. Never, never do his ghost the wrong than to hold your honor more precise and nice with others than with him. Let them alone. The marshal and the archbishop are strong. My Harry had but half their numbers. Today my eye hanging on Hotspur's neck have talked of Monmouth's grave.
Thank you.